welcome to Tooth and Nail TV episode 2. Check that out. Alright, in this episode we're going to talk to Ivoryline in the studio about the recording process of their new album. We're also going to be talking to the classic Crime, their new record Vagabonds, and how they feel about Haiti, right?
Woo! Yeah.
But whoa, Fair just came out with the new record. It's called Disappearing World, and this is a title track off of it. Disappearing World, check it out.
A little says a lot when writing from across the world, under the cover of the air. Open your letterbox each day to catch a glimpse of me, someone who's trying just to breathe. Don't ask my love, where is it that your peace comes from? I found it in a disappearing world. I found it in a disappearing world. I'm running out of time to make a sentimental plea. Pass off this trivial affair that made me motion sick to be displaced in history and separated by a scare. Don't ask my love, where is it that your peace comes from? I found it in a disappearing world. I found it in the beauty of a world whose intentions were not as clear as they could be. Reflection was not made to look like me, and whose intentions were not as clear as they could be, whose reflection was not made to look like me. Time to make a sentimental plea. Don't ask my love, where is it that your peace comes from? I found it in a disappearing world. I found it in the beauty of the world.
So we're in the studio right now with Ivoryline. They are currently recording their follow-up album to There Came a Lion. Why don't you guys tell us what that's all about?
Well, it's been awesome. It's been really good. Recording with Aaron Sprinkle again and Matt, who's behind the camera, who's a good man. There he is. We broke it up into two parts this time, which was kind of cool. We got to spend a little more time delving into the songs and the pre-production, which was good. Last time we just had literally about a day to get all the songs exactly how I wanted to record them. This time we had a week to really tweak and change and just align things the way we wanted and have Aaron get more involved with and more familiar with the songs.
It's real different the way it's laid out because we did, you know, a lot of pre-production and then we recorded the drums. Mm-hmm. And then we had scratch guitars to go with them. So instead of going ahead and starting to record bass, we went ahead and straight to vocals and writing. Mm-hmm. And getting the phrasing out for the vocals the remainder of the time we were here last, so that over the Christmas break we had the songs written and ready to go, and mm-hmm. the vocals were there, and the guys could think about them. And,
yeah, and then we just came back and we're like, hit the ground running. It's Aaron's favorite way to do records too, better. Which it's helpful when he's fresh all the time, and it helps him to have a break.
Yeah,
it helped us have a break
that it
too.
Was so luxurious to yeah. be able to have that break and to come back completely fresh.
Oh yeah, yeah. I was more involved in the writing of the guitar because I'm playing guitar now, and so that my influence brought a different element than the last record, and I think that changed things a little because obviously, you know, a different guitar player doesn't have the same taste in what they play and all that stuff. But the songs, I guess, I don't know. It's not, we didn't really set out to make them different on purpose. Just kind of
just
like,
different people.
Just
man.
Like.
It, the songs, our music that we write grew up with us.
Yeah, it just happened.
I think. It's more mature, there's more content, more dynamic, yeah. I think there's just more.
Well, the first album you guys recorded here, so you definitely got like a feel for Seattle and mm-hmm. the compound. So do you think that's added to maybe the comfort of this
oh
record?
Gosh.
Just like, kind of like returning to home or
yeah,
something
yeah,
like
yeah.
that?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It's twice as good.
And we're so much closer with Aaron as a person now. He's one of our best friends. We love him. That's what makes it so awesome. Hopefully the final product will reflect our hard work.
Are there any disaster type stories about this album? Has anything crazy happened?
Nothing at all.
Nothing.
One of Aaron's favorite jokes is, "Oh, we lost your record. We lost it. We deleted your
Sorry,
record."
We deleted
like he
your
said
record.
That to us the first time, and we were like, "That's not funny. Like, that's just not. This is not funny."
And then it got funny.
Yeah.
Whenever he would say it.
Yeah. Then it got funny, and then like, he has basically the most high-tech server drive that has two drives that write what you do on your computer. It saves it. And those two also automatically back themselves up in real time. So they're constantly backing each other up. When we started the record, one of the drives was already broken, but it didn't.
One of the main functions of the thing is to tell you when a drive is bad. And it didn't do that. And they already had a bad drive. And another one went bad while we were recording. The joke came true.
We couldn't access our record. It's still there on those hard drives. That are now have been shipped to Drive Savers to take the information out, but they're still there. Lord willing, they're still there.
Why?
Because we did half our record, about half of our record was done, and we had to stop.
So there's a chance that the record might be lost, and you guys might have to come back up here and re-record it. Worst case scenario.
There is a small chance of that.
Slim
yep.
chance, but
there is a small chance. But it looks like we won't have to. I like what's happening right now.
We're gonna go ahead and leave now. We're driving home.
Okay, bye.
Taking a little break in between recording session number 2 and number 3, only to come back and make really good music for you. So,
okay,
check
bye.
Out our MySpace, myspace.com/ivoryline.
But for now, watch our music video, Days In.
Like a boss.
Mercy at every day's end. Yeah.
Poema, Sing It Now. This record is amazing. It's awesome. If you know, you had your heart broken, or maybe you have a crush on somebody, or maybe you need music for your wedding, this album is perfect for it. But what do I know? Why don't we just talk to the band about it? We have them online via video chat.
Hey you guys, we're Poema. I'm Elle, and I'm Shailene. Our new album, Sing It Now, just came out on iTunes and in select stores on the 23rd, so you guys should maybe go check it out. We really hope you guys like it. There's about 6 songs on it, and yeah, you can get it on iTunes. It's only $5. Bargain. So yeah, we hope you guys pick it up and like it. Thanks.
As you might know, we're putting out an Emory triple pack entitled Are You Listening? Featuring the albums The Week's End, The Question, and I'm Only a Man. So now we put them into one budget item, so you have no excuse not to go and buy all three for the price of one. So check out Emory, Are You Listening? Hot Topic and Best Buy and stores near you.
Hot off the press.
Ah, look at that, just in time. Queen's Club, Young Giant, featuring previous members of The Chariot, who rumor has it was on tour through Europe, and the venue at night became a dance club, and the guys had so much fun, they wanted to create a band to keep the party going here in the States. Oh, look what just fell in from heaven. Brand new album by Secret and Whisper, Teenage Fantasy. If you know what's good for you, come April 6th, you'll be carrying around a copy of Teenage Fantasy 2. I'm not even a teenager, and it's my fantasy.
April 20th, we have two new bands coming out with full-length releases. We got Senpai Ravens called Our Graceful Words, definitely for the Almost Emory fans. And then Write This Down is also coming out that day. If you put A Day to Remember, Underoath, and Brand New in a blender, you would get this album. So enjoy a Write This Down smoothie.
Hey, Classic Crime, Vagabonds, coming out April 6th. You can pre-order this record right now for $10. $10, and part of the proceeds go to earthquake relief in Haiti. And speaking of Haiti, we have an interview with the band, the Classic Crime, right now, and they're going to talk about their experiences that they had in Haiti and how it was and everything they went through. And this was all before this crazy earthquake that happened, so check it out.
In November, we decided we were going to go to Haiti. Right after we got done recording our record, for me, my little sisters are from Haiti, and I've always wanted to go because my mom had gone and my sister had gone, and she'd adopted them from an orphanage in Haiti, and I kind of wanted to see where they were from, and you know, I'd heard a lot of stories, and I sort of have a connection there. Also, Sarah Freeman at Faceless International had told us a lot about it and said that we would love it, so. It was something that we looked at as an opportunity, being that Haiti's the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere. It's fairly close to us, and they need a lot of help, so we just wanted to focus there and see what we could do.
We hooked up with a friend of ours, Jason, who'd been down to Haiti before, knew this guy, Tom, who has this ministry. It's called Jesus in Haiti Ministry, and he has probably, I want to say, like 20 to 25 kids. So he has this big kind of old school like Haitian mansion, and he's adopted like all these kids. They help with the orphanage and a church there and a garbage place where people actually live. Imagine a garbage dump and people have built houses there and they eat scraps and like live there. So he's like, oh, just come down with an attitude of we don't know what we're gonna do. And we were just along for the ride, so we woke up in the morning, half the time didn't know what we were doing, and it was like, get in the truck, we're going to an orphanage, or we're going to a church, or we're going to Port-au-Prince, and we just kind of were there to help.
When I didn't really know what to expect, because we've seen poverty just driving down the streets, but when we got to the orphanage, there was just all these babies in the first room that were just, had very little food, they're just crying, there's flies all over them. And it broke my heart. I picked up one of the babies and she was crying and I held her in my arm and, you know, we just gave her water. And we tried to, keep her from crying, keep the flies away from her. So, I still think about that every night. You know, I really do. I pray for her and I hope she's alive and I hope she's well.
After we came back from Haiti, I personally felt like my life was honest to God changed, like, and it will be for the rest of my life. I at first did not want to go to Haiti whatsoever because, you know, when you hear, hey, let's go to Haiti, you know, it's just like, why would I want to go to Haiti? That sucks. Like, and pretty much, I mean, these guys, you know, were like, hey, well, you can come film this stuff, and we really need you to go with us, and we want to go as a band. And so I was like, well, you know, I guess I'll go and just kind of see how it is. And I you picture it on TV, you know, and what it would be like to be there, but it's nothing like being there. And not even when walking through the grocery store, I find myself, you know, holding up, you know, simple items that we personally can't feel like we can't live without every day, and look around, and it's just like, wow, we have this whole variety of food. And, you know, I just never realized how, like, blessed I am in the simplest of ways that we all, you know, take for granted.
When I first heard about the quake, I was really concerned for all of our friends there, because unlike other disasters that you hear about, we can put a face to it because we know people who are experiencing it. And so we were just really concerned initially, and I didn't know if a couple were safe. We heard through Tom's blog, he blogged as soon as he got the internet about what had gone on, and that there was wailing in the streets and crying, and people were homeless and sick and dying. And he goes around 18 hours a day and just delivers help and whatever he can. And he always usually ends up taking a few home with him. So his house is getting bigger, and he's just in dire need of support. Tooth and Nail's been awesome about getting the pre-order going, so that we can contribute all of our profits to Haiti and earthquake relief from the pre-order. If you pre-order on toothandnail.com, all of the profits from the pre-order will go into an account and will be donated to the ministry that we were involved in. And all this money is going to earthquake relief, food, water, medical supplies to people who are otherwise going to die. And so it's really important, and that's why we wanted to get it out quick, and that's why Tooth and Nail has been really good about getting it out quick, because it is important. And we're actually hoping to raise a decent amount of money with this, and we hope everyone pre-orders our record, even people that might not like it, just for the fact that it's given to a good cause, and hopefully we can do some good with it.
Another thing we're doing is we're here at the Moore Theater in Seattle. We're doing a big benefit show called Seattle Helping Haiti. We said, yeah, sure, we'll do it. You know, we want to help out. We just went to Haiti, and just a ton of people from the Seattle area, radio stations, businesses, just ton of people chipped in to help out, and hoping for a good turnout, and we'll raise some money to help the people in Haiti.
We're the Classic Crime. Thank you so much for listening to us.
Go to toothandnail.com if you want to pre-order our album and give to Haiti.
Took too long, but I'll write you this song. Now could you listen to me?
If not for moments, what's this life we lead? Tell me now, Jimmy, tell me you believe. 1,000 miles is not that far. It's complicated, but I'll make it that simple. Your pictures are the paper that lines my wall. I'm waiting for the moment you come back. I'm tearing up the pages of my heart. And what you need is what you get from me.
Tooth and Nail TV, episode 2 is Email us at tv@toothandnail.com to tell us your comments, any content you want to see, what we could be doing better. This is for you guys, so we want to know what you think. Follow us on Twitter, and we're going to check out the latest Underoath video, but first, we're going to watch B-Day Dance. Check it out. Thank you.
still gets home.